Good evening all. I've just started with a formatted card and it gives me 49 minutes of record time, which is actually pretty good for me, but because there's other things I want to do, I am going to buy a new card, and Nemo here has got one on at 1:15 in the morning. And the reason I'm so late is because I've been sitting watching a live stream for the past 3 hours. Good live stream. I hope it gets done again. You probably noticed already, I had to play around with OBS today and just used it to screen cap me playing a bit of Tetris on Facebook. I played a few games on that and, I had my little face up in the corner. So I'm pretty pleased with that. I really think I am going to invest in a few cameras similar to the one that I've currently got. And I can't thank Mark enough for this camera. I love it. I absolutely love this camera. Oh. So I will be looking on eBay in the near future, because like I said, I've got a webcam, which is what I used on that other video. It ain't bad. It's not the best, but it ain't bad. Actually, it's probably the best webcam I've used to date. It's only a Microsoft Lifecam. But the issue I've got at the minute, which I need to find a cure for. Thank you, Rainbow Dash. Is the fans on this are far too loud. I've got my webcam right on this corner of the monitor, and I can still hear the fans in that clearly. So I either need to move the PC again, or stick quiet fans on it, I believe. I've got a feeling it's that one and that one that's creating the noise. I don't think it's the front one. I have got other fans. I'm not sure. Ooh, I've got a friend request. Ooh. Hey, yep. What happened there? I thought we were already friends. Yeah. Unless he made a new account or something happened. I have known, to get unfriended from people completely at bloody random. Am I zoomed out? I am zoomed out, so yeah. I have got some other fans. I've actually got a couple of nice ones, but I don't know how quiet they are. If they're quieter than what I've already got on there, I will fit them, so I need to test them. That's alright. I think I'll just plug them into that and test them on that one. I'll disconnect the fans that are on it temporarily. I'll just plug in the two that I've got and just see if they are actually quieter. Because if they are, I'll put those on. It doesn't actually bother me, because after, I don't know, 2 or 3 years of using it, my ears are actually worth it. Lord, I must be getting tired. They're used to it by now, but it's not good for making videos. So I'll see if I can sort that out Monday. I've got an address printed off there, because I've got that metal detector to post. I need to get some ink for the printer. I could get some Repro ink cartridges for it, the cheapy ones, but the only problem with using those is your printer doesn't always recognise the cartridge, and yes, my left eye does squint a lot in light. The left eye's the weak one, by the way, for those that don't know. Anywho. Oh, that was the other thing. I got a parcel this morning Well, I got the card pushed through the letterbox yesterday. I found it when I came home last night from Mum's. And I picked up that box today. The lamps on top didn't come with it. I've got to post those. They are for a trade I'm doing. One of my Till Dawn Guardsmans and a lemon-lensed one of those. I actually hate that damn thing anyway, so I don't mind swapping it. But one of the eBayers I follow sent me another two lamps. He sent me another one of these to replace my old one, which gave up the ghost. The circuit gave out on it. And a nicer one of these. Look at that. It's the very first maxi light. An RMJ maxi light. So I've actually got two of those now. My other one, it's not broken or damaged. It's just, no, that's not the one, is it? That's the Mark II. When JSP started making them, I presume they bought the license or something. I don't know. But I can't find the other one. What have I done with it? I've got loads of them damn things. In my infinite wisdom, I thought that was a good idea to buy a box of 10. Seemed like a good idea at the time. Yeah. Oh, come on, it's a big bloody yellow lamp. Why can't I see it? It's in here. I took it off the shelf to put the new one up. I've literally just taken it off the damn... I haven't hidden it under this, have I? Nope. Just a laptop that's got to go in the cupboard. Wonder it'll be jiggered. Oh, as I'd... sold a couple of bicycles and that metal detector, I thought I would go and treat myself to some more Famosa plushies. So I picked up these three yesterday. I was going to say today, but it's not today. It's now yesterday. I think I've just confused myself with that. Here we go. So I picked up a Twilight, and I've got a stain on a leg already, which has really pissed me off. I've now got to try and get that out. Don't know whether to take this one to Mum's in the morning and see if she's got something that can take them stains off. It's actually not too noticeable. That really did tick me off, you know. Literally just buying as a stain on it already. So yeah, I picked up these three. Actually, I went back for Twilight, because the first time I went into QD stores, I just picked up Rarity and Rainbow Dash, the reason being they were the only ones on the shelf. There were still two Twilight Sparkles, an Applejack, and three Pinkie Pies. So, as it stands at the... You desperate for a pee or something, Rainbow Dash? Rarity's got front legs, and Twilight is leaning as far forwards as possible. None of these Famosa ones like to stand, though. They're not like the Build-A-Bears or the Olifactory ones. Those are my Olifactory ones. And I absolutely love the Olifactory design. Really do love them. I am planning to... get some more over time, you know, some, I don't know. I know they do quite a few. I know they do a bonbon. I can't remember. They've all been on the cider, haven't they? They have all been on the cider. I literally just need Pinkie Pie, but I ran out of cash. Well, I didn't, but, you know, I've got to save it for other things, unfortunately. That's the way life goes, though. I'm sure there was something else I want to show you. This camera works really, really well. I love it. I think I've got it set on 30 frames per second. I don't bloody know. And I can't remember what the resolution I've got it set on either. Ooh. I just know it works absolutely flawlessly. Right. Please tell me I'm not the only brony out there that has ponies on his bed. I don't know if you heard that, but according to Rainbow Dash, I am. That was perfect timing. Right. I'm going to have the big clean out again, that tub I don't want. I need to get ink for my printer. I've run out. Oh, and I've left that on. I'm just going to turn that off. If I can find the bloody button. There we go. Yeah, I've run out of ink. I need ink. So I'm going to have to see if I can get the cheaper remanufactured ones and hope the printer will recognise them, because they don't always. My old Lexmark, I used repro cartridges in that one, and there was one of them it just would not recognise no matter what I did. But the seller sent me out a replacement and it recognised that one. And, you know, it was exactly the same remanufactured cartridge. So, these printers can just get picky. I think it's something to do with the chips that are on them. Finally finished this as well. A little bit of a Lego subject as well. My mock fire appliance, which I don't know if I'm going to leave it as it is or try and lengthen it so I can put a crew cab on here, so it looks a bit more like a British truck. There's the war carrier. I think, yeah. What was it? I was talking to someone online earlier. I think it was online. And, No, it was a reply on a YouTube video. That's what it was on. Michelle Krieber, that was one of her videos. Excuse me, just coughed me lungs up. And she was talking about depression and the things she does, you know, to help with it. Well, there's lots of different types of depression. I mean, my autism can bring it on. You probably wouldn't even be able to tell that I had that unless I told you. Oh, there we go. I don't know what it is with these digital cameras, but they get hot. Anyway. Check my emails because I've got things still for sale. That's my receipt for that. Oh, right. Doi. No replies, but I will read that one in a minute. So that's how he did the rear arch. Sorry, I got sidetracked. I was just looking at that email. But then again, maybe I could dismantle that fire appliance over. I do apologise. Not done that all friggin' evening. And I put the camera on and I start hacking my guts up. That's typical, isn't it? And that has completely thrown me off track now and what I was talking about. tonally. I've completely lost the thread. I know I was talking about depression, but even that's, I've lost the thread on that now as well. I actually think I will extend my mock fire engine a little bit. He's done really well on that one though. Actually, no. I think I will leave it as it is. After all, I've not based it on any real truck. You know, it is literally my own creation and my own design. I have contacted Victory for a repair. Yeah. Let's just say I can't flush the toilet at the minute. Because I was doing a bit of cleaning in the bathroom, cleaning the window ledge down and whatnot. Picked up a glass, turned around, dropped the glass, and it punched a hole straight through the side of the toilet bowl. I do hope they ain't gonna charge me for that, because that is something I really could not afford. Besides, you know, it wasn't deliberate. It's actually close to the top of the bowl, so I can actually still use the toilet. And I could flush it with a bucket of water. But if I hit the actual flush mechanism, water's just going to go everywhere. So, yeah, I kind of can't do that at the minute. I've always got to have a whole new friggin' toilet fitted. Well, at least a toilet bowl, anyway. The rest of it is fine. I suppose I better clean it before they turn up. Sent repairs an email. I didn't see any point phoning it in as an emergency repair because the guys that, you know, stay on duty at weekends to do the emergency repairs, they only have what's on their van. You know, they can't get to the main yard to get anything, and usually there's no builders merchants open and whatnot, so I didn't see no point ringing that. And like I said, I can technically use it, so it's not a huge issue, but it's an issue that does need fixing. So I'm expecting a phone call. They're usually pretty good. I'm expecting a phone call at some point Monday. And that'll be to... The first one will probably be to let me know, you know, they've got it. Got the message and whatnot. And they'll pass it through to their contractors. And usually the contractors will contact you and arrange an appointment. I can't imagine they would leave that too long. But it's not going to be... I say it's not going to be an easy job. I suppose it's not going to be too hard. I've just got to break out the old bowl and seal in a new one. And, you know, just connect it straight to the drain pipe and connect the flush pipe to it. Simple. Bolt a seat post. A seat post. Fucking hell, did I really just say that? A seat on it. I've got bikes on the brain. That's why I said seat post. A fucking seat post. Well, you could try and sit on the toilet with a seat post, but I don't think it'd be very comfortable. So, yeah, so I just switched the camera on and used this one for the first time. I've already made a video update for my Lego channel. So, I figured I'd do one for the general channel. I actually started, you know, cutting up this box to pack that metal detector, then realised I've got no packing tape. So I've got to go and get that in the morning. Still got to buy a new toaster, because mine's half shit the bed, we'll say. Don't know where that term come from, shit the bed. I really don't know. It's just a weird one. It's something I've heard lots of various people use when things are pack up. Strange one, that one. Anyway, I'm not having my Hermes collect it this time. I'm going to Mum's tomorrow, so I figured I might as well get it all packed, get the label printed, and on the way to Mum's, we can just drop it off at the parcel shop. I don't think it will get collected till Monday, but it's done dust and dusted, so... Left a phone charger in. I don't like doing that either. Right. Yeah, so we have to go QD's and get some parcel tape in the morning. Nowhere opens till 10, so I don't really have to be up early anyway. Have I got any bread? Or am I going to have to go and get some? I know I've got some butter. It's the bread I want. Something to put in it. Right. Technically, lounge is tidied, bedroom is tidied-ish. I'm going to have to tackle the bathroom because I'm not having anyone working in that. I'm going to have a... That's what I started doing, cleaning up the bathroom. Because Mum's right, it probably doesn't do my own health that much good. Toaster on the shopping list. I'm sure there was something else that died that I had to add to the... Oh yeah, it's just a dodgy printer, but I can't show you this bit of paper, but I haven't checked it yet. That's weird, because I can't see any streaky lines on this one. It's actually printing text stuff off fine, but I suppose it's only really using the black ink, isn't it? It's not using the magenta nozzle or anything. Well, there isn't nothing on here that's magenta anyway. It's just black and white with a bit of blue, and even the blue is actually printed fine. So, and to be honest, I only print Hermes labels the most, so do I really need to get a new printer? Because I was going to because of that reason. But I've got it to print pictures good enough, so... And, ow, definitely going to need... ink. So, just something to do. So one thing I noticed, I don't know if I can change that in the settings on this camera, but I've got no timer, so I don't know how long I've been recording for. It just says the record in right there on my screen. Look at that, grey stuff all over my finger. Yes, grey stuff. That's a thermal paste, actually, off of a processor. Pardon me. Is it me or do I look like my eyes have just gone, either way? I don't even know I could do that. Ooh. Ending soon, get it now. Well, I would if I had the money, but I don't. So I can't get it now. What the hell did I cut? Oh, yeah. What is my printer? I know it's an Epson Stylus. What? Oh, come
me, you bastard.
Yeah. Epson Stainless. Cough your guts up. SX215. And it actually comes straight up under the suggestion, so there we go. You turn you around. Holy fucking moly! Are you serious? Nah. 30 ink cartridges for Epson Stylus SX215, 218, 205, DX8400 and 44. $9.99 for 30. Stuff me sideways and that's cheap. Really? Wow. Add to watch list. What's the feedback like? Over 80,000 feedback score and 99.5% positive feedback. We'll open that in another tab and just double check that. Look at that. So what do you actually get then? Is that picture what we actually get? 12 black, 6 cyan, 6 magenta, and 6 yellow. If the feedback has got 109 over the last 12 months, that's not actually that bad. Considering he's got well over 22,000 positive over the last 12 months. And I'm not seeing any red here. Not on this page. When was the latest of the last 1 month? Over the last 1 month, he's had 9 negative. Not sure about this one. Let's just go back. Okay. Well, that's just put me off because none of this feedback here, the positive, is actually related to the ink cartridges, and all that negative I saw or read is related to the ink cartridges. So, not actually sure. If something's too good to be true, what the f... 60? Is this the same seller? It is. They are ridiculously cheap. There's 12 for $5.79. Basically, 3 sets. A different one, and he's got slightly better. He's got 0.1% better feedback. Let's have a quick look. This one's looking a little more promising. Item wasn't correct, one for the printer. Let's have a look at the rest. cartridges leak to... Again, it's all to do with the ink cartridges. But then again, still prints wrong colour. Are you actually sure you put them in the correct things? Because I can't see why that would print the wrong colour otherwise. Oh, that's for a Canon, or even for the same, Then again, these are actually far cheaper, so I wouldn't be too miffed. And you can make an offer, so I could actually just square off to square £5. Right, I'll be buying them Thursday, as well as a memory card for this. I want at least a 32. Some boxed cartridges here, they're a little bit more. Now I'm getting tired. 22 ink cartridges for $7.98. It's tempting because you're thinking, wow, that's cheap for 22, but to be honest, would I trust them? No. Not fucking likely. There's a 20 ink cartridges. I think I'm going to stick with that other one I just looked at, I think. I've never done a Google Hangout before. I think I've got the equipment to do it now, you know. I've got a camera there, I've got a camera there. Here a cam, there a cam, everywhere a cam. Right. I'll call that quits, I think. So, thumbs up if you liked the video, thumbs down if you didn't. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you'd like to, and I will talk to you again very soon. Bye!